بركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. الحمد لله الذي بيده مقاليد الفرج، والصلاة والسلام على النبي الأمي صاحب الجبين الأبلج، المبعوث رحمة للعالمين بأقوم دين وأعظم منهج، وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين هم مفاتيح الرحمة ومصابيح السرج. أما بعد، اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما وعملا صالحين يا عفو يا كريم. So today inshallah tabaraka wa ta'ala we will continue where we left off from Al-Qawa'id Al-Arba', the four principles authored by Al-Shaykh Al-Mujaddid Al-Imam Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab بن سليمان بن علي التميمي النجدي الدرعي رحمه الله تعالى رحمة واسعة. And as we mentioned that this رسالة, this treatise of القواعد الأربع, it is very مختصر, it is very concise, and it is also very important that a Muslim knows these affairs, how to differentiate between shirk with Allah سبحانه وتعالى and what is not shirk. Because normally when we look at the state of the Muslims, then normally the Muslims, they think that the ayat which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed condemning shirk, making the dhamm of shirk with him subhanahu wa ta'ala, then these ayat were only revealed in condemnation of the idols that were worshipped by the kuffar of the Arab. These ayat were revealed in condemnation of those asnam, of those idols which were worshipped beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hence why many of the Muslims, they are of the opinion that we can never fall into shirk. How can you say that we commit shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of the heavens and the earth? When we believe Allah subhanahu, he is al-Khaliq, he is al-Raziq, he is al-Mudabbir, he is al-Muhyi, he is al-Mumit. How can we commit shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And the answer is, Abdurrahman, Abbas, what's the answer? Tawkhir? What's the answer? If a Muslim says, how can you say that we commit acts of shirk when we believe Allah is the creator, Allah is the Khaliq, Allah is the Raziq, Allah is the Mudabbir? Ji, Farisal.
That's the same response the Kuffar of Quraysh gave when they were questioning in regards to Iman. And so they affirmed Rububiyyah, Tawheed al-Rububiyyah generally, and they associate the partners in Allah's Uluhiyyah.
Exactly, mashallah. So this is the first qaida, yeah? The first qaida that we took, that the kuffar whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fought against, they believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. The majority of them, they do not believe in Allah subhanahu except that they commit shirk with him jalla wa ala. They also believed Allah was the creator, Allah is the sustainer, Allah is the one who gives life, Allah the jalla, he is the one who takes life away, he is the one who grants death subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the type of shirk that the kuffar of Quraysh fell into is the exact type of shirk that today the Muslims fall into, which is al-qaida tu-thaniya. The second qaida, the excuse of al-qurba and al-shafa'a, that we only seek nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through these graves, through these awliya, through these elders of ours, through our mashayikh. We go to the grave and we seek nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through them. We seek taqarrub to Allah subhanahu. We seek shafa'a from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through these. And that was the exact same response of the kuffar of Quraysh. مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَا إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى. We worship them in order that they take us near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هَؤُلَاءِ شُفَعَاؤُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. These are our intercessors with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this being the case, then the third qaida, which is today's lesson, is that shirk remains shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, irregardless which object is deified, irregardless which object is associated partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shirk remains shirk with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And then they say, look, you place these ayat of shirk, the ayat of the Quran which relate to shirk, upon our awliya, upon our Bazurgs, upon our elders, upon our saints, upon our babas. You place these ayat, where is Lat, Manat, Uzza, and where is Pir Abdul Qadir Jilani? Where is Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu? Where is Sayyidina Hussein radiallahu anhu? We call out to, these are our shufa'a. These take us near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can you take those ayat of the asnam, ayat of the idols, and place them upon our awliya, place them upon our saints that take us nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So this is what today's lesson is, that these ayat of Allah subhanahu, ayat of Quran, which condemn shirk, they are not just restricted to those asnam. They're not just restricted to those idols which the kuffar of the Arab worship beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we'll read inshaAllah ta'ala from the Al-Qaeda al-Thalitha inshaAllah.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursaleen nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma aghfir lina wa li shaykhina wa li walidayhi wal mashayikhihi wal muslimin ajma'in. قال المصنف إمام الدعوة محمد بن عبد الوهاب بن سليمان التميمي رحمه الله تعالى في كتابه قواعد الأربع، القاعدة الثالثة، أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ظهر على أناس متفرقين في عباداتهم، منهم من يعبد الشمس والقمر، ومنهم من يعبد الملائكة، ومنهم من يعبد الأنبياء والصالحين، ومنهم من يعبد الأشجار والأحجار، وقاتلهم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ولم يفرق بينهم، والدليل قوله تعالى: وقاتلوهم حتى لا تكون فتنة ويكون وقاتلوهم حتى لا تكون فتنة ويكون الدين كله لله. فدليل الشمس والقمر والقمر قوله تعالى: ومن آيات الليل والنهار والشمس والقمر، قمر لا تسجدوا للشمس ولا للقمر، لا تسجدوا للشمس ولا للقمر، واسجدوا لله، واسجدوا لله الذي خلقهن إن كنتم إياه تعبدون. ودليل الملائكة قوله تعالى: ويوم يحشرهم جميعا ثم يقول للملائكة: أهؤلاء إياكم كانوا يعبدون؟ قالوا: سبحانك أنت ولينا من دونهم، بل كانوا يعبدون الجن، أكثرهم بهم مؤمنون. ودليل الأنبياء قوله تعالى: وإذ قال الله يا عيسى بن مريم أأنت قلت للناس اتخذوني وأمي إلهين من دون الله؟ قال: سبحانك ما يكون لي أن أقول ما ليس لي بحق.
إن كنت قلته. So now this third qaida, third principle, that shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remains shirk with Allah dhul jalali wal ikram. Whatever a person performs sajda to, whatever a person performs tawaf around, whatever a person slaughters for its sake, then that is shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, irregardless what is deified. أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ ظَهَرَ عَلَىٰ أُنَاسٍ مُتَفَرِّقِينَ فِي عِبَادَاتِهِمْ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he appeared amongst a people who were very differed in regards to their worships. They were mutafarriqeen, they were separate in what they worship, different objects. مِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ الْمَلَائِكَ. Among them were those who worship the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. Among the people to whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent were those whom worship the righteous and those who worship the prophets alayhim salatu wa salam. Among them were those who worship trees and stones. Among them were those who worship the sun and the moon. وقاتلهم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ولم يفرق بينهم. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he waged war against all of them صلى الله عليه وسلم. ولم يفرق بينهم. And he did not differentiate between them. Now this one is worshipping a wali, salih, muttaqi. This one is worshipping a nabi. This one is worshipping a rasul. So therefore I will not fight against them. This person is worshipping a stone, a statue, a tree. So I will wage jihad against them. ولم يفرق بينهم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he did not differentiate between any of them. As we took last time, the hadith of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله تعالى عنهما, أمرت أن أقاتل الناس حتى يشهدوا أن لا إله إلا الله. I have been commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to wage war against the people until and unless they affirm لا إله إلا الله. But we said that they already affirmed لا إله إلا الله, because we mentioned with the munharifin, mubtadi'in, they translate la ilaha illallah to be la khaliqa illallah, la sani'a illallah, la raziqa illallah. And the kuffar of Quraysh, kuffar of the Arab, already they believe that. Hatta yashhadu an la ilaha illallah, until they believe la ilaha illallah, meaning la ma'buda bihaqqin illallah. There is no deity worthy of our worship in truth except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that which they worship beside Allah subhanahu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fought all of them, وَلَمْ يُفَرِّقْ بَيْنَهُمْ, and he did not differentiate between them. وَالدَّلِيلِ, and the evidence for that is the ayah of Surah Al-Anfal, وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ حَتَّى لَا تَكُونَ فِتْنَةً. And oh my Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wage war against them, وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ, until there is no more tribulation, until there is no more trial, until there is no more fitna, وَيَكُونَ الدِّينُ كُلُّهُ لِلَّهِ, and all of the religion is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here we see the importance of taking the fahm of the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. When we understand the ayat of Quran, then we take them how was understood by the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ اِهْتَدَوْا. The only way of guidance is the guidance of the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. Here Sayyidina Abdullah bin Abbas radiyallahu anhuma, he says here fitna, وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ, and wage war against them, حتى لا تكون فتنة, until there is no trial left, until there is no tribulation left. Here Sayyidina Abdullah bin Abbas said here fitna means shirk. Fight against them until there is no more shirk left. حتى لا تكون فتنة. Sayyidina Abdullah bin Abbas radiyallahu anhuma. Hence we see his great importance in tafsir. Allahumma فقهه في الدين وعلمه التأويل. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua specifically for Sayyidina Abdullah bin Abbas radiyallahu anhuma. Oh Allah, grant him understanding in this religion and grant him the interpretation of the ayat of Quran. وعلمه التأويل. Here he said وقاتلهم حتى لا تكون فتنة, means until there is no more shirk left. Until there is no more shirk left is your duty, oh my Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وقاتلوهم, wage war against them. ويكون الدين كله لله, and all of the religion is for Allah سبحانه وتعالى. The people worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى alone without associating any type of shirk with him. So the people in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were varied in what they used to worship beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Among them were those who used to worship the sun and the moon. وَدَلِيلُ الشَّمْسِ وَالْقَمَرِ. And the evidence that the fact that people used to worship the sun and the moon beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is statement of Allah. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارِ. From the signs of Allah Dhul Jalal is the day and the night. والشمس والقمر, and the sun and the moon. لا تسجدوا للشمس ولا للقمر. Do not prostrate. Sajda is an act of ibadah. Do not direct your worship, do not direct your sajda to the sun or to the moon, but rather direct your ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who khalaqahunna. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he created the sun and he created the moon, because the sun and the moon are two great ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is that sun which gives us life on this earth. It is that sun which allows the plants to grow. It is that sun which allows the fruit and the vegetation to grow. It is the heat and it is the light from the sun. And likewise, the moon is what grants a person some serenity at night. It is the light of the moon. The sun and the moon, وَجَعَلَ الشَّمْسَ سِرَاجًا. The sun as a burning lamp, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, placed in the sky. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed above us. Do not be, as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, do not be so impressed by that sun and that moon, which Allah subhanahu, He has created. How impressed should you be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who He is the one who He created that sun and He created that moon subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not make sajda to the sun, neither to the moon, as is famous from the people of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, where they used to worship the celestial beings. They used to worship the planetary, the sun and the moon and the stars in the sky. Then the people of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, they used to worship that beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The sun is what gives us light. And likewise, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa salam, he is nur, nurul hidayah. He is the light of guidance sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa salam. قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ. There has come to you from Allah subhanahu a light, the light of guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa salam, and an evident, manifest, clear book. He is the light of guidance sallallahu alayhi wa salam. The same way you have not been commanded to worship the sun or the moon because of the light that they emanate, then similarly, none of your acts of worship should be directed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is your majazi nur. He is your light, metaphorical light, the light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of hidayah and of rushd, of guidance sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallama. So among those who used to worship the sun and the moon, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the Khaliq, the creator of the sun and the moon. So do not direct your worship to that, rather direct your ibadah to the creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَدَلِيلُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. And the fact that people used to worship the angels of Allah subhanahu, such a great makhluq, such a great creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the angels who لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون, who they'd never disobey Allah subhanahu, whatever Allah the Jalal commands them, then they act upon that commandment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who there is no doubt in their righteousness, in their salah, in their piety before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Among them were those who used to worship the angels, as he mentions here. Which ayah was in your nuskha? وَدَلِيلُ الْمَلَائِكَ. The ayah of Surah Saba. طيب, my nuskha mentions the ayah from Surah Ali Imran. وَدَلِيلُ الْمَلَائِكَ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى وَلَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تَتَّخِذُوا الْمَلَائِكَةَ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ أَرْبَابًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, have never commanded you to take the angels and the prophets as arbab, as your lords beside him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because that mentioned the ayah of Surah Saba. Then Allah subhanahu mentions, وَيَوْمَ يَحْشُرُهُمْ جَمِيعًا. The day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather all of creation together on يوم القيامة. ثُمَّ يَقُولُ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, specifically questioning to the angels alayhim as-salatu was-salam, أَهَٰؤُلَاءِ إِيَّاكُمْ كَانُوا يَعْبُدُونَ. Is it you that they used to worship beside me? You, the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Did the people used to worship you beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The sun and the moon, no mushrik will say they are idols, they are asnam. The angels, no mushrik will say the angels are asnam, or idols which are worshipped beside Allah subhanahu. They are righteous slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بَلْ عِبَادٌ مُكْرَمُونَ. They are slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who are honored in this dunya and in the akhirah. And the angels, they will reply, سُبْحَانَكَ. Glory be to your Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anta waliyuna min dunihim. Oh Allah subhanahu, you are our guardian. You are our protector. You are our ally. Beside these people, whatever they used to worship in our name, oh Allah subhanahu, we are free from that. We have bara'ah from that. We are disassociated from that. You are our wali. You are our guardian in this dunya and in the akhirah. So the people used to worship the angels beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all of this, Imam Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab is bringing to break that shubha that these ayat of Quran which condemn shirk are restricted munhasara in the ibadatul awthan, ibadatul asnam, the worshipping of the idols, worshipping of statues and idols beside Allah subhanahu, because that is one of the greatest shubha of the mushrikeen, that these ayat are in condemnation of the idols that worship beside. How can you apply those ayat of shirk upon the awliya? Who can be greater in rank with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the angels alayhim salatu wa salam? Wa dalilul anbiya, and the evidence of the anbiya, people used to worship the prophets beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the ayah from Surah Al-Ma'idah, wa idh qala Allah ya Isa ibn Maryam. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will question, oh Isa ibn Maryam, أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُونِي وَأُمِّيَ إِلَهَيْنِ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. O Isa, did you command the people to take you and to take your mother as two gods beside me? Two gods beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُونِي وَأُمِّيَ إِلَهَيْنِ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. And this ayah is such a great blast on the people of shirk, because they look here, Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, he is a Nabi. He is a prophet sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Sayyida Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam, no Christian, no Nasrani will ever equate Sayyida Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam to be ilah. Do any of you brothers know any Christian who says Sayyida Maryam, Mother Mary, is a god, part of the Trinity? Any Christian say this? No Christian says this. But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions, إِلَهَيْنِ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. Oh Isa, did you command the people to take you and your mother as two gods beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? إِلَهَيْنِ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. And meaning she was a وَلِيَّة. She was a female wali, a person close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu described her as being taken as an ilah beside him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Exact same as people say that we seek nearness to Allah subhanahu through these awliya. The Christians say we seek nearness to God the Father through Maryam alayhi salatu wa salam, but they do not equate her to being an ilah. They did not equate her to being a god to be worshipped beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yet Allah subhanahu called her as if they took her as an ilah. They took her as a god to be worshipped beside Allah subhanahu. Qala subhanak. And Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wa salam will proclaim subhanak. Glory be to you, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I never commanded them except that which you told me subhanahu wa ta'ala. What was the commandment given Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wa salam? That you tell the people, ani'budullah rabbi wa rabbakum, that you worship Allah subhanahu, my rabb and your rabb. Your commandment to the people was a commandment of tawheed, of oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the people were mutafarriqeen. The people were differed in what they took as objects of worship beside Allah subhanahu, whether it was, we mentioned so far, the sun and the moon, the celestial beings, whether it was the angels of Allah subhanahu, whether it was the anbiya, the prophets sent by Allah subhanahu, none of them are idols. But yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala condemned that as shirk with him subhanahu wa ta'ala.
What did he say? قال المصنف رحمه الله تعالى ودليل الصالحين قوله تعالى
قل ادعوا الذين زعمتم من دونه فلا يملكون كشف الضر عنكم ولا تحويلا أولئك الذين يدعون يبتغون إلى ربهم الوسيلة أيهم أقرب ويرجون رحمته ويخافون عذابه إن عذاب ربك كان محظورا ودليل الأشجار والأحجار قوله تعالى أفرأيتم اللات والعزى ومناة الثالثة الأخرى وحديث أبي واقد الليث رضي الله عنه قال خرجنا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى حنين ونحن حدثاء عهد بكفر وللمشركين سدرة يعكفون عندها وينوطون بها أسلحتهم يقال لها ذات أنواط فمررنا بسدرة فقلنا يا رسول الله اجعل لنا ذات أنواط كما لهم ذات أنواط فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الله أكبر إنها السنن قلتم والذي نفسي بيده كما قالت بنو إسرائيل لموسى اجعل لنا إلها كما لهم آلهة.
So in the evidence of the Salihin, that the people took the Salihin, the righteous and the pious slaves, to be gods beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is what Allah Jalla mentions in Surah Al-Isra. قُلِ دَعُوا الَّذِينَ زَعَمْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِهِ Say, call upon those who you claim beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I remember once I had a discussion with somebody who was trying to justify this type of shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That, yeah, you can call upon the awliya, you can call up. He said, look, Allah says, Allah commands, قُلِ دَعُوا الَّذِينَ زَعَمْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِهِ قُلِ دَعُوا الَّذِينَ زَعَمْتُمْ Say to them, call upon them. Allah commands, Allah gives fi'l amr to call upon those who you claim are your awliya beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He didn't understand that this Allah subhanahu is using this language to make inkar upon them, to rebuke them for what they are doing in their action, calling upon others beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلِ دَعُوا الَّذِينَ زَعَمْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِهِ فَلَا يَمْلِكُونَ كَشْفَ الضُّرِّ عَنْكُمْ وَلَا تَحْوِيلًا If only he read the second part of the ayah. Say, call upon those who you claim are your awliya beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَا يَمْلِكُونَ كَشْفَ الضُّرِّ Allah says, they are unable to remove any hardship from you. وَلَا تَحْوِيلًا Neither are they able to change any of your situation. This is the hal. This is the situation of those who you call upon beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they are unable to do anything. Whoever they are, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes them, amwatun ghayru ahya, wama yash'uruna ayyana yub'athun. They have died and they are not living and they are unaware when they will be resurrected. How can they do any goodness for you? How can they perform any feats of miracles for you? How can they aid you and how can they assist you? All of those who are worshipped beside Allah subhanahu, look in Surah Fatir, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it explicitly clear. يُولِجُ اللَّيْلَ فِي النَّهَارِ وَيُولِجُ النَّهَارَ فِي اللَّيْلِ وَسَخَّرَ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرِ كُلٌّ يَجَرِي لِأَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ لَهُ الْمُلْكِ Allah subhanahu makes mention of these ayat of his rububiyya to establish hujjah against the mushrikeen. That it is he subhanahu wa ta'ala who he merges the night into the day and he merges the day into the night. And Allah subhanahu, he is the one who has subjugated the sun and the moon, each one of them traveling in their own orbit. ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ That is Allah who is your Lord. No wali, no sheikh, no peer has this power. ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ That is your Lord, Allah لَهُ الْمُلْكُ To him belongs the dominion. To him belongs the kingdom of the heavens and the earth. وَالَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ مَا يَمْلِكُونَ مِن قِطْمِيرٍ And those who you call upon beside Allah subhanahu, Allah, this is him. He is the one who has power over the heavens and the earth, the sun and the moon, the night and the day. And those who you call upon beside him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah didn't say, والأصنام التي تدعونها من دونه. Allah didn't say those idols which you call upon beside him. Allah mentioned generally those who you call upon beside him. والذين تدعون من دونه ما يملكون من قطمير. They do not possess قطمير. Generally, you know what is قطمير. ما يملكون من قطمير. Angie.
It's the it's like the membrane of a date of a the seed of a date.
Exactly. So the date, the tamar, kajur, which we eat the date, and the seed inside of it. They call it seed, yeah. The seed inside. Then you plant that seed, and another tree will grow from that seed. But on top of the seed, if you've ever paid attention to that seed, date seed, then on top of that seed is a very, very thin membrane. That is called as qitmir, which you do not eat, rather you throw it away. That which you do not need, لا تحتاج إليه أصلاً. That which you don't even need, you don't require, you don't eat, ما يملكون من قطمير. They do not even possess that thin membrane over the date. Those who you call upon beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والذين تدعون من دونه ما يملكون من قطمير. إن تدعوهم, if you call upon them, لا يسمعوا دعاءكم. They are unable to listen, unable to hear your calling upon them. ولو سمعوا, that's your loss in this world, that they cannot even hear what you are asking from them. ولو سمعوا, and even if they were to hear, ما استجابوا لكم, they would be unable to respond to you. They would be unable to give an answer to what you are calling upon them for. ويوم القيامة يكفرون بشرككم. On the day of resurrection, they will disassociate from your shirk with them. They will ويوم القيامة يكفرون بشرككم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you call it استغاثة, call it وسيلة, call it whatever you like. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called it shirk with him. ويوم القيامة يكفرون بشرككم. So those salihin, those righteous people, Allah subhanahu mentions لا يملكون كشف الضر عنكم. They are unable to remove any difficulty, any harm from you. ولا تحويلا. Neither are they able to have any sort of change in this world. أولئك الذين يدعون. Those people. ولا يرحمك الله. أولئك الذين يدعون يبتغون إلى ربهم الوسيلة. The Muslim will say, here, look. Allah mentions وسيلة, وسيلة. يبتغون إلى ربهم الوسيلة. But then Allah is talking about those awliya, those salihin who you are calling upon. They used to seek nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were righteous. They used to try their best to gain nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أيهم أقرب ويرجون رحمته ويخافون عذابه. They used to have hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu. They used to fear the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet with their piety, with their righteousness, for you, they are unable to anything for you. لا يملكون كشف الضر عنكم. They are unable to ward away any difficulty, any harm, any detriment from you. And on يوم القيامة, they will disassociate from you. So what is the faida? What is the benefit in going to their grave and seeking nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through them in the same manner like the kuffar of Quraysh, kuffar of the Arab, they used to do. ودليل الأشجار. And also here, this ayah of Surah Al-Isra, Sayyidina Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu in Sahih Muslim, he said here, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ يَبْتَغُونَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمُ الْوَسِيلَةِ. This ayah is referring to نَفَرٌ مِّنَ الْجِنِّ, a group of the jinn who the kuffar of the Arab used to worship beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can any sane person claim that the jinn are idols worship beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَدَلِيلُ الْأَشْجَارِ, and the evidence of the trees and the stones that worship beside Allah is the ayah from Surah Al-Najm. أَفَرَأَيْتُمُ اللَّاتَ وَالْعِزَّى وَمَنَاتَ الثَّالِثَةَ الْأُخْرَى. Have you seen Lat and Manat and Uzza? These main idols that worship beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lat, which the people of Taif, Mu'ayyid, people of Taif used to worship Lat. Lat was, as we mentioned, كان اللات رجلا. Lat was not only an idol. Behind that idol was the ideology of a person. كان اللات رجلا يلت السويق للحاج. He used to make this sawiq for the hujjaj. It's not only an idol. It's not so people just one day they carved an idol and started worshipping it. Behind that is a human being who used to perform good actions for the people. And Uzza is a tree that was between Makkah and Medina that the people used to worship. And likewise, Manat was a stone, was a statue, an idol that they used to worship beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وحديث أبي واقد الليثي and the hadith in Sunan Tirmidhi of Sayyidina Abu Waqid الليثي رضي الله تعالى عنه الحارث بن عوف. He says that خرجنا مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى حنين. We went out with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam toward Hunayn after the conquest of Makkah. In which year? Eighth year of Hijri. After the conquest, Fath of Makkah, then after a couple of days, after a few number of days, then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he left toward Hunayn. With him were 10,000 of the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum ajma'een, and likewise the inhabitants of Makkah who accepted Islam just recently, around about 2,000 of them. 12,000 marched toward Hunayn. خرجنا مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى حنين ونحن حدثاء عهد بكفر. And we were new to Islam. We had just left kufr. We just left idolatry. We left our disbelief around the 2,000 of the inhabitants of Makkah, and we were new to Islam. وَلِلْمُشْرِكِينَ سِدْرًا And the mushrikeen had a tree, يَعْكُفُونَ عِنْدَهَا Which they would devote themselves to. وَيَنُوطُونَ بِهَا أَسْلِحَتَهُمْ And they would hang their weaponry upon this tree. Why? What was the reasoning of طلب البركة, to seek baraka from this tree, from this يقال لها ذات أنواط, which was called as ذات أنواط. The kuffar, the mushrikeen, had this tree called ذات أنواط, which they used to devote themselves toward, and which they used to hang their weaponry upon to seek baraka. And I asked, do Muslims say no, go to the graves and place their shawls and place things upon the graves for baraka? Exact same. They used to hang their asliha, hang their weaponry upon this tree for barakah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi was, they said, فَمَرَنَّا بِصَدْرَ بِصِدْرَ فَقُلْنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ اِجْعَلْ لَنَا ذَاتَ أَنْوَاطٍ كَمَا لَهُمْ ذَاتُ أَنْوَاطٍ And we asked, who? Those new Muslims. وَنَحْنُ حُدَثَاءُ عَهْدٍ بِكُفْرٍ Those new Muslims asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, make for us a sidra, make for us a tree, how these mushrikeen have a tree, from which they gain barakah on their weaponry. Ya Rasulullah, make us, place for us a sidra also. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahu Akbar. How great is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهَا السُّنَنْ Verily, this is the same way as those who came before you. قُلْتُمْ وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ كَمَا قَالَتْ بَنُو إِسْرَائِيلَ لِمُوسَى You have said by Allah, the same way Banu Israel said to Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wassalam, اِجْعَلْ لَنَا إِلَهًا كَمَا لَهُمْ آلِهَا And how ajib is the statement of Banu Israel. When did Banu Israel say to Sayyidina Musa, اِجْعَلْ لَنَا إِلَهًا كَمَا لَهُمْ آلِهَا
G? They made a statue of the...
No. When?
Some people worshiping some idols.
But when?
After they passed the... I think after they crossed the
sea. Exactly, mashallah. After they passed the sea, yeah? After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed them to escape Fir'aun. Escape Fir'aun and his army. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala split the sea for them. They passed by the sea. And after having passed by the sea, they came across a people who had idols which they worshipped beside Allah subhanahu. And after having this great ayah shown to them, Banu Israel, they said, instead of being mashkur, instead of being grateful to Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, asking, ya Musa, how can we be grateful to Allah for having saved us from this punishment, this torment of Fir'aun and his people, they said to him, اجعل لنا إلها كما لهم آلهة. Make for us a god the same way they have gods. And here, you know, العبرة بعموم اللفظ لا بخصوص السبب. Here the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he applied this ayah upon this action. اجعل لنا سدرا كما لهم سدرا. اجعل لنا ذات أنواط كما لهم ذات أنواط. And the ayah mentioned the word إله. اجعل لنا إلها كما لهم آلهة. No, none of them believed that this شجرة, this ذات أنواط, is an إله, is a god. None of them believed that. They sought tabarruk from this tree. They saw blessings from this tree, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he applied on that the ayah, اجعل لنا إلها كما لهم آلهة. So how can these mushrikeen say to you that you have placed the ayat of shirk upon our awliya, upon our saints, upon our pious people? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he placed these ayat upon not only those who they worship beside Allah subhanahu, that which they sought tabarruk from, that which they sought blessings from beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ala al-fawr ankara alayhim. Immediately he rebuked them. He alayhi salatu wasalam rebuked them for this statement. Was it a statement of shirk? This statement, اجعل لنا ذات أنواط كما لهم ذات أنواط. Like you mentioned, this was from the mouths of those Sahaba who they were new to Islam. How long had they been Muslim? Couple of days, maybe a week. So they were very, very new to Islam. Otherwise, they did not, أعوذ بالله, commit shirk. This was not the commitment of shirk. They did not commit shirk with this sidra. Rather, they just asked it, the question to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he immediately made inkar upon them. So this again shows for us the khatar and the danger of committing shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That all of these ayat show that, what is the point Shaykh al-Islam is trying to make for us? That all these ayat show and these ahadith show that shirk is not munhasar. Shirk is not contained only within worshipping idols. Rather, whatever object, acts of worship are performed toward that, irregardless what it is, irregardless who it is, that is shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So next week, inshaAllah ta'ala, we'll take the final qa'ida, al-qa'idatul rabi'a. And because this topic is a very sensitive topic, therefore next week, inshaAllah, we'll have something extra, inshaAllah ta'ala, where we'll have a different brother. He will give us a little reminder on the mawani' al-takfir, mawani', the factors that prevent a person declaring people as kuffar and declaring people as mushrikeen. Because these actions are actions of shirk, but you go around labeling kafir, 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 mushrik, 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 mushrik. No, this is not our tariqah. This is not our manhaj. So in regards to some of these mawani' of takfir, some preventative factors of labeling people as mushrikeen and kafirin, we'll take that inshaAllah ta'ala next week. And the next week we'll conclude this mubarak text of Al-Qawa'id الأربع إن شاء الله تعالى. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. دكتور مؤيد.